In this video, I show you how to create a Windows 10 ISO image file. If this video helps you, please remember to like, subscribe, click the bell to receive notifications, and leave a comment down below. Welcome, my name is Joe. Now let's get straight into creating a Windows 10 ISO image file. The first thing we need to do is download the media creation tool from Windows. So type in media creation tool and press enter. The first option that pops up is from Microsoft, and as you can see, it says download Windows 10 disk image ISO file. Click onto that. If you're having trouble locating that link, I'll put a reference in the description below. Now, when you look at the page, you've got the update here. This is actually going to update your computer, which you don't want to do. You want to come down here to the installation media file. So download the tool now. It's going to start downloading in the bottom corner. If you're on a different web browser, you may see it slightly differently, but once it's downloaded, click onto it. Select yes at the security prompt. The installer will pop up and it's going to get everything ready for you. On this screen, click the accept button. And here you have two options. You can upgrade the PC, which we do not want to do. And then you've got the create the media drive, DVD or ISO file, and on this particular instance we're interested in the ISO file. Now Windows will try and automatically detect which version you want depending on the computer that you're currently on. These are my settings here. If you don't want these settings or you want some additional options, you can untick this box and then all of the options become selectable. For my requirements, I'm going to keep the recommended settings. And that's because I'm going to be installing this into a VirtualBox later on. And then click the next button. Here you've got the option for a bootable USB flash drive. You would need one in the computer at this point if you want to boot it from a USB or an ISO file. We're clicking the ISO file here. Now it gives me the location to save it to. In this case, I'm just going to send it to the desktop. And it's called Windows. I'm going to label that Windows 10 and click the save. This process here can take quite a while. It's downloading the whole Windows 10 package onto the computer and putting it into an ISO file. And the ISO file has been created. To check that, just bring up a file explorer and go to the location you saved it. As you can see, Windows 10 ISO file is now there. It's about 4 GB in size. So going back to the Windows 10 setup installer, just finish there and it's going to close down and get rid of all of the temporary files that it had saved. Remember to like, subscribe and leave a comment. Thanks very much for your time and I'll see you in the next video.